Welcome to the third of the five-part video series on A to Z PowerPoint tips, tricks, and hacks. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. K is for Ctrl K. It's a useful shortcut you can use to link an object on a slide to another slide or to a web page. Let me show you how to do that. Let us say we have a slide deck which has four slides. I want to be able to click on some object on slide 1 so I can go directly to slide 3. Let me show you how I can do that. Let me go to the first slide. First, let us insert a shape onto the slide. I'm going to use this rectangular shape and let me draw a random rectangle here. Then let me use the shortcut called Ctrl K, which is the shortcut for link. Now, to link this to slide 3 in the same presentation, I need to go to this option called Place in this document. And here I can see the various slides. When I click on slide 3, I can see a preview. Once I confirm that this is the slide that I want this object to link to, I can say OK. Now, when I go to slideshow, when I place my cursor over this shape, you can see that it automatically converts into a hand icon. When I click on it, I go to slide 3. So using this technique, you can connect one slide to another and create a beautiful interactive slide deck. On the iCard, I will leave a link to a step-by-step tutorial on how to create an interactive slide deck. Now let us move forward and see how we can link an object to a website. Once again, let us insert a shape. Let us pick up the same rectangle tool and place this over here. Now when I click on this rectangle, I should be able to go to a specific site. The website that I want to go to is presentationprocess.com and the specific page that I want to go to is selected already. I'm going to select this and press Ctrl C, which is the shortcut for copy. And then let us get back to our presentation and I'm going to link this object to the specific address that I just copied. Now let me press Ctrl K, which is the shortcut for link. Then let us go to the option called existing file or web page. So let us go here. And then in the address column, I'm going to paste what I've already copied. So let me click here and press Ctrl V. Now that link is pasted. I'm going to say OK. Now when I go to slideshow, I can click on this and that will take me directly to this page. So that is how you use Ctrl K shortcut to build links within a slide deck or to a website. L is for lock drawing mode. It is an interesting time-saving option that most presenters are not aware of. Let me show you how it works. Now, take a look at these shapes here. I'm trying to build an organization chart. Let us say I want to connect these boxes. The inefficient way of going about it is, you go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From lines, you pick up this tool, which is the connector tool, and then you connect this to this. Once again, go to Auto Shapes Gallery. Look for the specific tool, click on it, and then make the connection to the next box. This can take a lot of time and it can be quite repetitive and boring. Let me show you a smarter way. This time I go to Auto Shapes Gallery, locate the specific tool, but instead of pressing left mouse click, I'm going to right click on that shape and here I have the option called Lock Drawing Mode. Let me click on it. Now you can see that my cursor has changed. Now I can connect one shape to another and then I can continue using the same tool over and over again. Now see this, I'm going to click on this once again and then connect it to the next one. And then I'm going to connect this to the next one and then to the next one. Can you see here, it is that easy for me to use the same shape over and over again by using the option called Lock Drawing Mode. It can save you a whole bunch of time when you know how to use it and when to use it. M is for add music to your slides. Let me show you how to do it. The first step is to download the music you want to use in your presentations. There are so many places from where you can get free, copyright-free music. Even YouTube Audio Library offers you some wonderful options. Once you download the music and store it in a folder on your computer, we will learn how to insert that music onto your slides. First, go to Insert. Then go to Audio, click on Audio on my PC. Here I have downloaded some music. I'm going to select the first one and say Insert. Now I have the music inserted onto my slide. As soon as you click on this icon, you get this contextual tab called Playback tab. Now here you can decide how you want to play the music. You can have the music play in click sequence, or you can have it play automatically. You can either play the music on one slide where you have inserted the audio file, or you can choose to play it across slides by clicking on this option here. You can either choose to have the song end as soon as the file is over, or you can have the music loop over and over by clicking on this option here. Now, as far as this ugly icon that shows on the slide, you can choose to have it hidden during slideshow. For that, all you need to do is to click on this option called Hide during slideshow. Now, when I go to slideshow, you will see that the music starts playing and also that this icon doesn't appear. Isn't that nice? Now let me hit Escape. Here you can choose to have the volume levels for your music, be it low, medium, high, or even mute. You can also trim the audio to the length you required by going to this Trim Audio option. You can also fade in and fade out the music. There are a whole bunch of options that allow you to use the music the way you want on your slides. Before we go to the next step, remember, if you want to create beautiful slides, even if you don't have the time, skill, or patience to create them, you can check out our professional PowerPoint templates collection by clicking on the link in the description box below the video. It is the smartest way to create top-notch slides fast. N is for notes or speaker notes. Do you want to reduce clutter on your slides? Do you want to impress your audience with statistics that is not there on your slide? Do you want to rehearse with impact so you can captivate your audience during a live presentation? Then you need to know how to use notes well. It is one of those wonderful options available in PowerPoint, but is not used that often by presenters. First, let me show you how notes can help you reduce clutter on your slides. Take a look at this slide, for example. There is way too much going on here. There is a picture and there is a whole bunch of text. And when a slide is so busy and when you show this to your audience, they usually tune out. Now, let me show you a different way you can present the same slide. Can you see it only has the visual? Now, when I want to present the information, I click and draw the viewer's attention to the first point, which is RAM locking handle. Then I provide my explanation. Once it is done, I take the viewer's attention to the next one, which is driving pulley, provide the explanation, and then I click and show the third point and make my explanation. Now you might ask, Ramgopal, it's all fine. The reason why I had all that text on my slide is so I can refer to it whenever I make my presentation. Now that I don't have any text that I can refer to, how would I present properly? That is where the magic of presenter view comes in. I've created a separate video that shows you how to use presenter view like a pro. I will leave the link to that in the iCard here. Now, let me quickly show you the power of the combination of notes and presenter view. To access presenter view, you need to use the combination called Alt F5 on your keyboard. The moment you do that, you get this view. Now, this is the slide that I showed you earlier. This is the view that your audience gets. And this whole thing is the view that you get, which means you can refer to your speaker notes here. All we have done is to shift the text that was on the slide to the notes section, so your audience gets an uncluttered view of the slide and you get full access to the text that you've written earlier. The notes is also the place where you can write some key statistics which you can rattle off, which is not available on the slide. This will definitely impress your audience. Moreover, in presenter view, you get this special panel called as Next Animation, which shows you what is going to come next on click when you have animation on your slides. So, if you are going to use animation in your presentation, then using presenter view can be such a big game changer. Now, let me hit Escape to come out of the presenter view. To write your notes, all you need to do is to go to the status bar here, click on the option called Notes, and that opens up the panel. Now, you can always readjust the size of the notes by moving your handle here like this and then write whatever you want here in the notes section. And when you use presenter view, this is what is going to show in the notes page. So go ahead and take your presentations to the next level by using notes option in PowerPoint. O is for orientation of slides. Most of us assume that the only use for PowerPoint is to create slides for presentations. But actually, PowerPoint can be used in far more ways than you can imagine. You can use PowerPoint to create invitations, flyers, brochures, certificates, and so much more. First, I'll show you how to change the orientation of a slide from the default landscape to portrait. Then I'll show you how to precisely customize the slide size and dimensions to suit your specific requirements. All you need to do to customize slide dimensions is to go to the Design tab of PowerPoint. Then to the far right, you can see this option called Slide Size. You click on the drop-down menu, and here you have the option for custom slide size. When you click on that, you will be given this dialog box where you can choose the orientation. If you want the slide to be in a portrait mode, you can click on that option and say OK. Now you are asked if you want the content to be maximized or do you want the content to ensure fit. In this case, I'm going to choose ensure fit, and you can see that this is the result. I can always move these elements wherever I want, and then I can start building my content underneath. And as you can see, this looks more like a flyer. Now, if I want to define my custom slide size, I can go to the same slide size option here, go to custom slide size, and here I can define the width and the height to suit my requirements. What is more, if you want to go for some predefined dimensions, you can click on the drop-down menu here, and you can choose from any of these options. You can have A3 paper size, A4 paper size, and so on. So the next time someone tells you that PowerPoint can only be used to create slides for presentations, show them this video. So you saw the tips from K to O, but what about the other tips from A onwards? To make it easy for you to watch the other videos in this series one after another, we created a short playlist here. So just click on this link right away and start watching the tips right from A for autocorrect.